coach lesson 19. It's writing and evaluating expressions, specifically working with exponents, identifying the base and the exponent, and then working a little bit with order of operations, or as you guys probably know it as from your past teachers and from me, as PEM does. So first we're just going to look at a couple things as a reminder with some exponents. When we have a expanded expression like this, like 8 times 8 times 8, we know that there's a more simple way to write this by using an exponent. Since all of these are the same, we call that our base. The base here, or the repeated factor, is going to be 8. Now, since that 8 is being multiplied by itself, it's the repeated factor, 3 times, we can write that as 8 to the third power. That exponent tells us that that 8 is being multiplied by itself 3 times. Okay? Now, we could do this the other way around. By expanding an expression when we have it already in exponential form. So we have 9 to the 4th power, which really means if we expand it and write it out the same way that that first problem was, we're taking that base of 9, which is that expanded factor, that repeated factor that's being multiplied by itself, 4 times. So we're going to write it as 9 times 9 times 9 times 9. 9 times itself 4 times, repeated 4 times. Now we have a bit of a reminder about the order of operations. And like I said, you guys probably know it as PEM does. P standing for parentheses. Next, it would be exponents. Multiplication and division go hand in hand. You read it like a book and you do whatever's first, left to right. And then the addition and the subtraction go hand in hand too. Same thing, you would read it like a book and do them whatever comes first, left and right together as a pair. So they have an example over here to the right. They have 6 times the quantity of because it is in those parentheses, 2 plus 3 to the third power. Now, according to PEMDAS, the order of operations, which we need to do in this order, we're going to do the parentheses first. So 2 plus 3 is going to give us 5. We're going to remove the parentheses since we've done that operation. I actually am a fan of crossing off the order, or the operation that we've done, so I can see that I've done it and then I can move on to the next one. I can see next we're going to do the exponent. As we discussed just previously, this means that we're going to multiply 5 3 times. So you can see that they do that over here. 5 times 5 times 5 is 125, and we're left with just 6 times 125. Now, ironically, multiplication is our next order in the operations, but it's actually all that we have left, so we're just going to finish that out, and you can see that we're going to get an answer of 750. Okay, let's do a little bit of practice here. In this first section, they have us just writing the expanded form in exponential form. So here I can see that 5 is my repeated factor, which is going to be my base, and it's being multiplied 1, 2, 3, 4 times is going to be my exponent. Number 4, you can see they're having us do it the other way around, like that second example. They have it in exponential form, and we're going to write it in expanded form. We're multiplying 6 as that repeated factor 3 times, so we're going to write it as 6 times 6 times 6, okay? Down here, I'd like to point out this word, evaluate. You're going to hear me say it all year. Evaluate is a big fancy word that they use that also means to solve. We're actually finding an answer to these ones. So, 9 is our base, our repeated factor. We're multiplying it 2 times, and they actually want us to do what? They want us to evaluate it, so we're going to do 9 times 9, which would give us 81. Okay, let me scroll down a little bit further, and we are just going to try one of these order of operations, and I'll have you guys do the rest on your own. We'll do number 15. I am a fan of writing out PEMDAS as a reminder, and we're going to go ahead and do the operations in the order that they are suggested to do. So I'm looking for any parentheses, which I see, so I am going to do this operation first. I'm going to rewrite everything that I do not use, so I make sure that I'm not trying to do too many things at once. I'm just going to focus on one operation at a time. 4 plus 1 is within that parentheses, which is 5. going to rewrite that squared that to the second power because I didn't use it yet. I'm going to cross off my p. I've done my parentheses. Next is going to be exponents. So I'm going to focus right here on this 5 to the second power. So I'm going to rewrite everything that I did not use yet. And then I'm going to focus on that 5 to the second power. 5 is my repeated factor. I'm going to multiply it twice. 5 times 5 is 25. I'm going to cross off my e. I've done my exponent. Now, again, ironically, division comes here next, almost next in the order. Multiplication and division go together. If there were a multiplication after this division, we would do the division first since we read it from left to right. In this case, we only have one more operation left, so we're just going to divide. 100 divided by 25 is going to give us an answer of 4.